Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. Last weekend, the crazed California Congresswoman Maxine Waters said that anyone who sees members from Trump's cabinet in a restaurant, or a department store, or at a gasoline station, should create a crowd in order to push back on them. And to tell them, they're not welcome anymore, anywhere. These comments obviously sparked condemnation across the political spectrum, from both sides of the aisle. She later told MSNBC that protesters are going to absolutely harass them. But now she has added this, trending, breaking, major outbreak at U.S. hospital, hazmat evacuation in progress. So there you have it, folks, even her own party is telling Maxine Waters to stop it. And thankfully for us Republicans, she isn't stopping, in fact, she's doubling down on her horrible words. This fully illustrates how much turmoil the Democrat Party is really in, and in how much trouble they are when it comes to the November midterms. Here is more via Patriot Journal. She attacked her fellow leaders, and now the whole party is about to disintegrate right before the midterms. Americans can thank her for the 2018 red wave. This November, there will be many important elections. Democrats want to take back Congress in the hopes of ousting Trump. Unless patriots take to the polls, they very well might have their way. But there are some signs that things aren't going so well for Democrats. Namely, all the infighting. The party is barely holding it together. Droves of Americans are abandoning them. Democrats are becoming more and more extreme. And now some of their own are lashing at their fellow party members. From the right scoop, I love it when the left turns on their own. In this new feud, Maxine Waters hits back at Chuck Schumer and Nancy Pelosi after they turned on her for calling on liberals to harass Trump officials. What makes this even more delicious is that Waters denied that Schumer and Pelosi disagreed with her call at first. Now she's saying that they'll say anything to stay in power. Love it. Here's when Mad Maxine said Pelosi and Schumer didn't really disagree with her. I wonder what changed her dim-witted mind? Maxine Waters is becoming the face of the Democratic Party. That's pretty bad, for them. Waters is a deranged lunatic. She is pushing to impeach the President of the United States based on nothing but her hate. Not a great platform to win over Americans. As the far-left media continues to push Waters to the forefront, the rest of the party is panicking. For all their belly aching, they can't convince most of America to hate Trump. Pelosi and Schumer know they need to dial back the impeachment talk. Good luck with that. It's quite surprising to see the party fracture apart. They had a chance to remedy their plight. They could have joined with the president and found compromises. Nope. Instead, they decide to torch their chances at ever be relevant again. November is going to be very interesting. Funny that good old Auntie Maxine talks about the U.S. having a housing crisis when she herself can't live in her own district because it's not safe. A district she has represented since 2013 and is today worse than 5 years ago when she came into office. This is what Judicial Watch had to say about Waters via Fox News. Judicial Watch sent a hand-delivered letter Monday to the chairman and co-chairman of the House Office of Congressional Ethics calling for an investigation into whether Rep. Maxine Waters, D. Kaloff, violated House ethics rules by encouraging violence against Trump administration cabinet members. The Office of Congressional Ethics describes itself on its website as an independent, nonpartisan entity charged with reviewing allegations of misconduct against members, offices, and staff of the U.S. House of Representatives and, when appropriate, referring matters to the House Committee on Ethics. Waters addressed a rally in Los Angeles on Saturday and told a crowd, "If you see anybody from that cabinet in a restaurant, in a department store, at a gasoline station, you get out and you create a crowd and you push back on them. And you tell them that they are not welcome, anymore, anywhere." In Judicial Watch's letter to former Rep. Doc Hastings, R. Washington, and former Representative David Skaggs, D. Colo, of the Office of Congressional Ethics, I pointed out that Waters encouraging individuals to create crowds who will push back on President Trump's cabinet members at private business establishments in an apparent effort to prevent these cabinet officials from obtaining basic necessities without fear of assault and violence. Representative Waters seems to be in a violation of House rules, specifically a rule that states, a member, delegate, resident commissioner, officer, or employee of the House shall conduct himself at all times in a manner that shall reflect creditably on the House, House Rule 23, Clause 1. Most Americans from both sides of the political aisle dislike this rhetoric. and the left will suffer for it in November. But most importantly, what I want to know is what kind of people elect and re-elect someone like Maxine Waters to anything? Is this really the best and brightest the Democrat Party in California can do? Who am I kidding? Yes, it is the best the Democrat Party can do, and it fully explains how they have managed to turn a once glorious golden state full of opportunity and beauty into a third world crime and poverty infested cesspool. This is the best part about having President Trump. He has been awesome at weeding out the crazies in the political arena, don't you agree?